Dan.
Our coverage continues of Championship Week live from Center Park Stadium in Atlanta, Georgia. It is the Flag Football Division II Championship classifications 5A through 6A. Lithia Springs in Dodge County clashing for a state championship. Good afternoon. I'm Wiley Ballard, joined by the state's foremost expert on flag football, David Reynolds. And when it comes to the sport of flag football, it has been growing leaps and bounds year after year. It began in 2018 as a sort of county-only sport up in Gwinnett, just north of Midtown Atlanta. And then 2019 added about four or five more counties. And then last year, David, it got into a GHSA sanctioned sports status where we crowned state champions last year. Now in year two, the number of competing teams has nearly doubled to close to 200.
Really exciting to see what we have in flag football in the state of Georgia. The first year, 2019, all 19 high schools in Gwinnett County Public Schools played flag football. Had a state county championship at the Mercedes-Benz that year. Next year, it grew to six more counties across the metro Atlanta area. Also hosted the state championship there at the Mercedes-Benz Stadium. 2020, Georgia High School. Kudos to Georgia High School for having a sanctioned flag football now. But in 2020, we had 91 teams play flag football. A little challenge there with the COVID and kind of learning how to deal with that. And then 2021, this year, saw nothing but growth in flag football in the state of Georgia. 189 teams are now playing flag football in the sanctioned sport. Still room to grow. Have about 450 schools in Georgia High School. So still plenty of room to grow in flag football. Excited about the energy and the speed of the game. If you ask anybody across the state of Georgia, we've seen nothing but involvement and people jumping on board. A lot of multiple sport athletes that we'll see. So we'll grab athletes from softball, volleyball, track and field, and soccer, to name a few. But very excited about the growth of flag football.
And many of those teams are getting up to speed. In fact, Lithia Springs, their first year as a flag football program, Dodge County in their second season. And in the past couple of years, they've gone through learning the rules, the differences between tackle football and flag football. So let's do the same here before we get started this afternoon with the distinctions between flag football and tackle football.
So the field today will be 80 yards long and 40 yards wide. First downs will be achieved by gaining the zone, line to gain, which are fixed 20 yards apart. We'll play two 20-minute halves for the first 19 minutes, being a running clock. Once we get under 1 minute of the half, the clock will run similar to high school tackle football, so the clock will stop on incomplete passes, scores, and so forth. Every player will be eligible to catch a forward pass, no matter where they start on the field, including your snapper, your center. Last one, flag football is a non-contact, contact sport, so think of basketball. When we think about not initiating contact with our opponents, instead of seeing our hands being used to block today, we'll see a lot of screen blocking out there on the football field.
So now that we've got the business out of the way, let's focus on the players. And the first name you've got to focus on when you see Dodge County flag football, Altiera Gooch. She is a game breaker on both sides of the ball, Dave.
Yeah, pretty exciting for this junior to fly around. Number 21, Altiera Gooch, wide receiver and safety. Leads the team with catches, has six touchdowns on the season. Leads the entire classification with 15 interceptions on defense. Flag football interceptions are critical. She does average one interception per game, which is a complete game changer. And that's exactly what Altiera Gooch has come to Center Park Stadium to do, is to change the game.
Now, she's not the only two-way star on the field this afternoon. For Lithia Springs, Nevaeh Shedrick, team's leading tackler defensively, and she can do a lot on the offensive end.
Just a sophomore here, number nine, running back and linebacker. Team captain, leads a team with carries. Also leads a team with flag pulls, so leading on both sides of the football. Multi-sport athlete who pulls flags with a complete attitude flying around the field. When the offense is all gas and no breaks, this sophomore running back linebacker is having a really good day.
And Shedrick will begin on defense as the Lions have won the toss and opted to defer. So Dodge County will start on offense first. You take a look at the field here. This is very important. The end zones are the 10-yard line to the goal line on this tackle field. It's just an 80-yard field, so we'll play between the 10s, if you will, midfield. Still the 50-yard line, although the 40-yard line in your stat book. And there are no kickoffs in this sport, Dave, which means that Dodge County will begin first and six on their own 14-yard line, although it will be the 24-yard line. And so Dodge County, their journey to the state finals began with a couple of shutout wins over Locust Grove and Rockdale County, edged Trinity Christian in the quarters, and then defeated Riverwood outside of Mercedes-Benz Stadium on Monday. These two teams, this Class 5A, 6A matchup, was actually the semifinal games that were played at the Home Depot backyard outside of Mercedes-Benz Stadium before weather interfered with the rest of our semifinals. Meanwhile, for Lithia Springs, again, their first year of flag football, their scores have been awfully tight. They have relied on their defense. They've yet to score more than 7 points in a playoff game this year.
Just like the coach said, Coach Pleasance, you know, the harder you work, the further you advance. And even though they're the three seed out of their area, playing highest caliber flag football at the right time, and again, low numbers right there, but as long as you score more points than they do, you advance to the next round.
And as we get set for the first play of this state championship, let's go to the man on the field, Nelly. Here's John Nelson.
Thank you, Wiley. My biggest thing is I've got a question for the guy sitting to your right. I want to know what it's like for David, our guru of everything flag football, to see this go to where it has been. We go from two championships last year. This is the second of three this year. What's it been like for him to see this sport continue to grow and evolve, considering last week in the state of Alabama, they had their first flag football championships, and it was a game between Hewitt Trustful and Smith Station and went down to the wire. What's it been like for David to see this growth?
So just another reason here with flag football that Georgia is the leader in the country. We have five states across the country that are playing flag football sanctioned, and so it'll continue to grow. But again, Georgia's on the forefront of this movement here, the excitement, the energy, the high passion behind girls flag football.
And we were there at the semifinals when some high school coaches from the state of Montana came all the way to the Southeast United States to watch flag football in person. And hey, you can't be camera shy in a state final now. See you, Dodge County. Very excited to have a chance to compete for a state championship after the Indians were knocked out in the quarterfinals last year by Greenbrier. Look at Dodge's quarterback, Annie Jones. She's a great tennis player, as many of these flag football players are multi-sport athletes. And for Jones, she rushed for two touchdowns in that 13-6 win over Riverwood on Monday. So here we go, first and six from the quote-unquote 14-yard line. And it begins by Jones on the bootleg right. Splits the defenders, but they've got the flag. Good pull there by the front line. Around Annie Jones for Dodge County. A couple of names to keep an eye on. Don't lose track of number 11, Sky Meadows. She leads the team with six touchdowns receiving, and then Illeshia Mitchell, number 14, a senior running back. She had 88 yards rushing and 20 yards receiving in that semifinal win. And for Dodge, it was their first game without their star player, Sinai Searles, who went down with injury, and as we understand it, not going to play today. There is Illeshia Mitchell, and we spoke with Coach Clint Sanders, and he told us Mitchell really was the MVP of that game for the way she stepped up. Lithia Springs, meanwhile, their defense has been their standard, their ace in the hole, and here's a look at how they line up. Imani Roberts, the lone rusher, she'll be putting pressure on Jones. Trio linebackers. And then on the back line, Hannah McIver, 14 interceptions in the secondary. Anaya Moore, the safety. So after a gain of nine, on the rush by Jones, first and 17. And, oh, great pull! Imani Roberts with those long arms.
Nice job there on the rusher. You know, didn't start the season as the rusher, but come into this role very nicely. And again, the effort here is laying out. Keep playing. Get that flag pulled. Very nice pursuit there, applying pressure to the quarterback.
So well done by Imani Roberts. Gain of only one, second down and 16. They must get to midfield. Pick up a first down. Over the middle, intercepted, picked off. Lithia Springs racing it back. This is Anaya Moore, and she's all the way deep into Dodge County territory. But we have a flag on the play.
Illegal contact on the intercepting team. 10 yards from the spot of the foul, first down.
So it happened after the interception. Ian Boosie, our head referee, there's the rest of his four-man crew. So it was after the interception, so it's still Lithia Springs football. It's the ninth interception of the year from Jones.
Yeah, again, you know, the legal contact there, blocking downfield. We cannot initiate the contact there. So number 23 on the side of that camera angle, blocking downfield, can't have that.
So they've got to get to the 30-yard line on this tackle football field for a first down. And right there, a tackle for loss, Anaya Showers. She was a linebacker last year, now a rusher, and she gets in the backfield. Quarterback for Lithia Springs. It's really been a two-player effort at that position. Rashaya Minix gets the start. She's the sophomore quarterback, but doesn't necessarily have that deep ball in her pocket. Last two games, she's just 5 for 10 for 5 yards. This is a run-oriented offense when she is in at quarterback. And a dropped handoff, and that'll go back to the spot of where the ball landed. Again, all fumbles in flag football are dead as soon as they hit the ground. So Nevaeh Shendrick couldn't handle it. And here's the rest of Lithia Springs offense. Some key players who will contribute. Again, Hannah McIver leads the team with 6 touchdown receptions, but this is a run-oriented offense. Shendrick, 9 touchdowns, over 700 yards in just 18 games. And this time, it is Shendrick around the right side, and she steps out of bounds. And it makes it a 4th and shorter now.
Nice job here, number 9, getting on the edge, using that speed right there, and just outruns the defender. Maybe not a very good angle there by Hope Sheffield in the corner. But again, like you just said, brings up a little 4th down and more manageable than what it was.
Offense elects to go for it.
And they're going to go for it. There you have it. If again, in flag football, you have the option to either punt or go for it. There are no field goals. Only way to score is by getting into the end zone. And on 4th and 4, you're not going to gain much in field position. And 4 yards isn't that much to go for, considering it's a 20-yard zone. And Shedrick's got it, but a flag comes on the backside of the play. We'll hear what the call is.
Illegal contact on the offense. 10 yards.
So although we pick up the first down right there on the run, we'll see the blocking downfield. Again, that's illegal contact all day.
That's Kendra Pleasance.
4th down. Offense elects to go for it.
Pleasance leading his first-year program. She was a high school basketball player, played in college at Chattahoochee Valley Community College. In her 3rd year at Lithia Springs, she was the JV basketball coach, and when she got the opportunity in May to be the head coach for flag football, she said, absolutely. Still going for it here. 4th and 11. Throw out the line of scrimmage. Good move. Getting upfield. Oh, but a better pull. A few yards shy. Nice work by Isaiah Phillips to make it close. But Dodge County gets the tackle.
So again, short underneath pass right there. Does make an opponent miss or two, and then again, the Indians flying around on defense to prevent the first down there, so we'll have a turnover on downs.
And Hope Sheffield making the stop after missing that last tackle on the run from Shedrick. So here's the Dodge County offense, a group that averages over 20 points a game. That's pretty good for a 40-minute running clock sport. And they use a lot of different players. And a tackle in the backfield, Imani Roberts means business. That's her 2nd tackle for loss.
Again, applying the pressure up front, critical, making that quarterback make decisions as much as possible. Again, just nothing doing here. 23, get up the field, not playing the fake. Right to the point of attack right there. Nice flag pull.
Now, in flag football, you know, it would jump out to you in tackle, at least, of how she really went unblocked. That's not nearly as uncommon, considering only seven players on the field and everyone's eligible to receive a pass. As that pass secured by Altier and Gooch, but doesn't go anywhere with it. Isaiah Phillips with the pull. And so far, this Lithia Springs defense playing like they have all postseason long. They've given up just one score in four playoff games. That was a touchdown in the second round against Noonan. A direct snap. This is Mitchell. Lets it fly and bobbled, incomplete. Anaya Moore cutting in front of Micaiah Robertson, who was the intended receiver. And a punt coming for Dodge.
Probably ill-advised pass right here, trying to force this ball to double coverage. Nice job, number 16 right there. Safety coming over the top and helping out. Fourth down, again, you have to declare if you're going to punt or go for it. And being on the minus side of the field, we're going to punt.
We have yet to see a full first down. Dodge County did pick up the first down on their first and six to open up the game. But since, we haven't seen a first down for either side. And once the punt is touched, it is down and dead. And now here comes Lithia Springs, their offense out for a second possession.
Okay, so we both have one possession each so far. Everybody calm down. The light's pretty bright there at Center Park Stadium, but you fought all year in the past four rounds to be here. So let's see what kind of adjustments we make as coaches coming out for the second drive for each team here.
Yeah, it's first and 12. Got to get to midfield. And here is Rashaya Minix. The run-oriented offense for Lithia Springs. They'll load up the right side. Dodge County still playing it straight. Zigzagging up the middle, Isaiah Phillips.
Yeah, junior number 10 receiver right there on the jet sweep. Just trying to get athletes here in motion. Try to get them in space, see what we can do. If we can make one girl miss on the flag pull, we'll pick up several more yards right there. So, again, be on time here with the offense. Keep pushing downfield as much as we can in this run offense.
7-yard gain, looking to get to midfield. Again, they go to Phillips. Around the right side, the flag comes out. A little extra contact there perhaps from Hope Sheffield, number 12 in red. Officiating crew will talk it over.
Illegal contact on the offense. 10 yards from the spot of the foul. Replay, second down.
That's a blocking foul, correct, David?
Yeah, I didn't see it completely live. If maybe the defender's just standing there and Phillips just ran right through. I'm not sure what happened out there.
By the way, here's a look at the defense for Dodge County. Anaya Showers, their senior rusher. Mitchell and Etheridge, the linebackers, and now the secondary. Leonard Ray Whitley and Altira Gooch with 15 interceptions. Third penalty on Lithia Springs. 30 yards thus far, and that snap is dropped. It's going to be a loss of nearly 5 yards. Dodge County led by head coach Clint Sanders in his second year. They had their hearts broken, he said, in that quarterfinal loss against Greenbrier where they dropped the snap in the end zone for a safety through a pick six that ended their season. This year they've won 13 straight, but the big challenge in this semifinal and now championship games has been trying to replace their star do-it-all, Sanai Searles, who is the team's leading rusher. And another flag on Lithia Springs. Start that time. The quarterback has come in for Lithia Springs as well, Kasaja West. And Coach Pleasance and her staff trying to tell her team, settle down here. Don't try and do too much. Too many penalties thus far for Lithia Springs, especially in a game which defense has been the story. So Kasaja West, she's got the big arm. Fires it a little too strong that time. Looking for Hannah McIver. How about that moment we saw in the semifinal for Lithia Springs? Kasaja West came in. Fourth down and about 15 or so from the 35-yard line. Her first play of the game, trailing 2-0 late, and she uncorks a 35-yard touchdown pass to Hannah McIver to win the game.
Absolute bomb earlier this week by the freshman quarterback in the biggest moment on the biggest stage in program history.
Here's the punt, and not fielded cleanly, so it'll be dead. And we'll step aside. So Lithia Springs, Dodge County, the Division II final, classes 5A and 6A, scoreless.
Of an eye, so many tomorrows can disappear. Buckle up for your future every trip, every time. A message from the Governor's Office of Highway Safety.
The Georgia Student Finance Commission urges high school seniors needing college financial aid to submit their FAFSA. Millions of dollars are left on the table each year because students don't submit their FAFSA form. More at gafutures.org.
Cigna is a proud partner of Georgia Public Broadcasting and Football Fridays. Cigna's mission is to improve the health, well-being, and peace of mind of those we serve. Learn more at cigna.com/take control to learn how you can help support your physical and emotional well-being.
There's a lot of anticipation in the air right now.
Well, how special is it playing in a state championship game? Just ask Dodge County head coach Clint Sanders. He has been in the high school coaching ranks since the mid-90s. And I asked him before today, when was the last time you competed or were a part of a state championship game? He said, well, my freshman year of high school at Mary Persons High in 1984, our football team lost in the state finals. That's the last time I've been involved in a state championship game. And his Indians have the ball. We come out of a timeout. And they put it in the belly of Anaya Showers.
Yeah, I'd expect here for the Dodge County Indians offense to get the ball out a little quicker. Again, with number 23 up front for the Lions applying that quick pressure. That's a good job there at getting the ball on the edge. A little adjustment there made by the Dodge County Indians.
How about this, too? Clint Sanders coaching flag football. He spent most of his career as a tackle football coach. First team he ever coached, a flag football team. Auburn intramural flag football in 1991. He enjoyed it so much, he changed his major from engineering to education. Found his vocation at an early age. And that pass no good, looking for Ina Purvis. And the center in any offense in flag football, but especially for Dodge, is a big part of what they do. Ina Purvis, Coach Sanders calls her the rock he needed to build the offense around. She said she prefers to play defense, but team needed her at center, and so she made that sacrifice.
Yeah, very consistent snaps that she has up front. And then again, like I said, in the open, your center is eligible to catch a forward pass, which for those that play tackle football, that is a big no-no.
Dodge entered this series with just 9 total yards of offense. This is their third possession. An interception and then a punt have been the first two. And a late pitch. What a play. Was the flag out? That'll be the question. But Illeshia Mitchell on the receiving end of that lateral.
So we set up a hook and ladder here. And I believe the second pass.
On the offense. 5-yard penalty. Loss of down. It'll be fourth down.
Yeah, so that second pass is going to be forward, which is 2 forward passes, which is illegal forward pass. A good call there by Sheldon Smith, line judge, right on top of it.
Offense elects the punt.
Illegal forward pass is a 5-yard penalty and a loss of down, so a big backbreaker there as they would have picked up the first down.
So the 11-yard gain is wiped out, but again, in flag football, when the fumbles are dead, as soon as they hit the ground, you're not as nearly as against trying to lateral. And look at this punt all the way just in front of the goal line. It's picked up and a great tackle on the coverage. Isaiah Phillips tried to turn it upfield, but she got nowhere. Altiera Gooch making her impact felt. 48-yard punt. Makaya Robertson couldn't draw it up any better.
Gets the roll right there and then just lets your kicking team get down the field. A lot of athletes on this field flying around. So nice job there, flipping the field, flipping the possession in the Indians' favor.
Lithia Springs is on their own 6-yard line, if you will. The 10-yard line is the end zone. The give is to Phillips. Around the right side, up the sideline. Did she stay in bounds? I don't believe so. But that has been their bread and butter today here, Dave, is just giving it mainly to Phillips and letting her take it around the right side.
Yeah, and the adjustment there made by Lithia Springs is several times they had the illegal blocking downfield. And you can see in the replay here, some of the receivers down the field right there were stationary, were not moving, making it very challenging for the defense to get there. Can't miss flag pulls there, especially if you're my impact player of the game. You can't miss flag pulls there. Luckily, that goal line right there is out of bounds. And so we'll play to live another day.
It's an 80-yard field lengthwise, just 40 yards wide. And now the cutback and a good pull, Carson Etheridge. He led the team in tackles last year. And after that 27-yard rush, Dodge County did a nice job of sealing off that edge and turning her back inside. Rashaya Menix in at quarterback. We saw a brief appearance from the gunslinger, Kasasia West. Menix fires it over the middle, batted away by Gooch. And again, those long arms, she's able to break up just about everything. Best of luck if you want to go up against her.
Yeah, and that's why the junior safety already has 15 interceptions on the season. Trying to roll the pocket a little bit here, blocking to slow down, showers up front, and then really nice job defensively there to not draw the flag for defensive pass interference, but get the pass breakup.
I think that shot of the blocking was also instructive. You cannot use your hands to block, just your torso. Nice breakup that time from Illeshia Mitchell.
Yeah, go with the underneath route here. Third and long, maybe trying to get something short instead of a manual fourth down. But nice job swarming to the ball right there. Number 14, the senior linebacker, brings up a fourth down and we'll punt and try to flip the field again.
There will be a stop of the clock at the 1 minute mark, at which point the clock will work like normal tackle football rules. A poor punt, great catch and hands. Oh, how about that play? From Glenna Ray Whitley, just a freshman for Dodge County. All she had to do was touch it, and it would have been down there. But she was able to haul it in and pick up a few more yards.
And maybe this is why the freshman chose flag football over softball. Nice heads up right there, good IQ. Just get the ball and get back upfield. Nice change of momo right here at the end of the first half for Dodge County, potentially.
It was only a 13-yard punt, a 12-yard return, so on the whole, Dodge County surrendered just a yard from the line of scrimmage. It's now first and four. They've got to get to the 30 on the field. Little reverse. Mitchell weaving back in. And the pull made, you guessed it, Imani Roberts again, and we'll hit the 1 minute warning.
No worries here to take. A little risk right here in a little short run, knowing you have the 1 minute warning come up. Now that we're under 1 minute of the half, the clock will start with incomplete passes. If the play runs out of bounds, those kind of things. The clock will keep running, though, if we get a fumble inbounds, all that kind of stuff. So normal tackle football rules here for the clock under 1 minute of the half.
Tighter package now for Dodge County as they mix up their sets. Annie Jones jetting through. She's got the first down. Anaya Kendrick with the stop. Boy, Jones does a nice job getting north and south, doesn't she?
Yeah, nice job here, senior quarterback, faking the run one way, and just using that speed, that blazing speed to get up the field. And again, nice flag pull there by Kendrick, the linebacker, but we've already gained several yards in the first down.
Both teams get just three timeouts for the entire game, so Dodge County not using one here. The end zone is the 10-yard line on this field. There's a little hook and ladder. Gains a couple of yards.
Nice job by the Lions there of sniffing that.
Dodge County.
Sniffing out that hook and ladder, which is a relatively trick play. Just nothing going right there. We saw earlier on and see it again. That second pitch is backwards, which is completely legal. But again, got to pull the flags the first time we get a shot. When we do, we'll be successful on defense.
There's Illeshia Mitchell. And for Coach Sanders, I'm sure in some ways he's thinking, this might be the deepest I get into Lithia Springs territory all day. They really struggled to move the ball their first three possessions.
Need to capitalize on the short punt and the nice return that set up this nice field position. Correct. With limited field position, limited possessions, and we know Lithia Springs' defense has been stout all postseason long. This might be a golden opportunity here. We've got to take advantage of it when we get it.
The Lions have allowed just one touchdown in their last five games. Second down and 12. The 10-yard line is the end zone. Dodge County bunches them up around the center. Jones going deep left, a little high for her intended target, Carson Etheridge. She's caught a touchdown in back-to-back games entering play today. Good coverage by my Angel Ross.
Yeah, nice job here. Taking a shot here. Why not? Incomplete pass again. Stops the clock there. Just overfires a little bit. Man, we would love to have that one back if you're from Eastman, Georgia.
Jones just 1-for-4 passing. And that one catch was a loss of 2 yards. They've got two shots to get to the 10-yard line to score a touchdown. And that time, a little miscommunication on the route, but the flags come out. Looks like Etheridge may have drawn the flag.
Pass interference on the defense. Half the distance to the goal. Replay, third down.
Yeah, definitely get a little contact here. Lucky for Dodge County, there was nobody over there, but that's not the rule. As long as we have contact, we have pass interference. So draws the flag. We'll replay the down, similar to tackle football here. So it's not an automatic first down. We'll replay from the 6-yard line.
Jones over the middle, dangerous pass, and it lands behind the scrum, looking for Altiera Gooch. No better target for Dodge County. For Lithia Springs, this would be a huge goal line stand for Coach Kendra Pleasance and her group. Their defense has been their calling card, and they got to summon one more big stop here.
Yeah, Ben, don't break the motto of the Lions all year long on defense. Need to stand up right here at the end of the first half.
They've tried to go to the air a couple times here. Haven't had much success. Only need 6 yards. Go to the air again. Open it. Coming from nowhere. It's busted up. Hannah McIver. Perhaps a touchdown-saving swat.
Yeah, Dodge County drew up the play of the dirt here. We get the look that we want from Coach Lowry, offense coordinator. And then, like you said, number four, just flying to the football right there. Boom. Nice job. Not today, not right here. Nice job.
Huge breakup.
Very good. So now we'll flip the possession here. Maybe take a shot here. Probably just run the ball and get in the locker room at halftime here.
Hannah McIver leads the team in interceptions. At that time, all she needed to do was knock it down. So on the six, they go around. Stop made by Micaiah Robertson, and that ought to do it. So Dodge County comes close to cashing in that poor punt, but Lithia Springs, the Lion defense, stands strong, and we are scoreless with 20 minutes gone. And the Division II Class 5A through 6A final. Nothing decided in our second flag football game of the day. You're watching Georgia High School Football Flag State Championships on GPB Sports.
DBHDD's Red Ribbon campaign is about all Georgians standing together for substance abuse prevention. Stay in the game and live drug-free. Learn more about healthy alternatives and living a drug-free lifestyle at garedribbon.org.
Besties are seedless, sweet Satsuma mandarins grown by Corbett Brothers Farms in Georgia. Besties are juicy, easy to peel, and a great addition to lunches or afternoon snacks. Available at supermarkets near you. Share with your bestie.
I'm Rick Steves. Join me for the Best of the Alps. We'll travel through five different alpine countries and see some of Europe's most iconic mountains. Along the way, we'll conquer many of these peaks, enjoying plenty of thin air thrills. We'll explore charming alpine towns filling remote valleys and climb to cliff-hanging villages. And finally, we'll hike from easy day trips to a classic long-distance tour.
Now streaming on GPB Passport.
GPB is free to all citizens of Georgia across 9 television stations, 18 radio stations, and innovative education and digital divisions. For over 50 years, GPB has grown with the community, highlighting the very best of Georgia, challenging, educating, documenting, rejoicing, delivering quality PBS and award-winning local productions to 98% of Georgians. Show your support by visiting gpb.org.
My television neighbor, I'm glad we're together again.
Hey there, welcome in to our GPB halftime show presented by Regions. Get back in the game with Regions Bank. I'm Nikki Noto-Palmer, and we are live from our studios in Midtown Atlanta. Welcome in. If you're just now joining us, we're currently at halftime of the Division II of our flag football state championship. We are scoreless. It's Lithia Springs and Dodge. So far, it's been a great game, and we've got more of that coming up. But first, we have actually crowned one state championship already. It's our Division I. Winner of our flag state championship, and that goes to Southeast Bullock. In their very first year of having the program, they won 20-0. And let's move along to our Division II score. And then let's go ahead and take a look at our Georgia's EMC championship schedule and scoreboard. EMC is more than electricity. Let's go ahead and take a look at the rest of what we have going on. Division II right here for the 5A-6A. As you can see, we're scoreless at the half of Lithia Springs versus Dodge. Next up, we're going to have the Division III game, which is the 7A teams battling it out. It's Hillgrove versus Marietta. This is the third meeting of these teams this season. Followed by the single A private game. It's Trinity versus Prince Avenue. This is a rematch. A lot of eyes are going to be on this game. Then we're going to close out Thursday's slate of games for the single A public state championship. And that is none other than Irwin County and Brooks County, two teams we have seen play before. It is their fourth meeting in two seasons. So we have a lot of great games coming up for you today. Again, this is only day one. We've got games on Friday. We've got games on Saturday. We'll talk about those a little bit later. But first, let's go ahead and bring in our friend John Nelson, who is weathering the elements down at Center Park Stadium in the city. John, what's going on over there?
Well, it's not quite elements yet, but we're getting to the elements. At least, you know, maybe if the elements could just bypass us, it'd be great. But right now it's in the 50s, gray skies, kind of working their way back and forth a little bit. You're getting a little sunshine, but you have the teams that are coming up just around the corner. Actually, Nikki, Marietta has been here a while. They checked in here at Center Park a while ago. They've been watching this game from the absolute beginning. And one of the cool things that we've gotten to see in the first two games, Portal brought their pet band for their game, the first game here on the day. And we got the Lithia Springs pet band off to my right, off to my left, camera right. So you're getting these kind of sights and sounds that are really serious about showing their support for their two schools. You know, we talk about Dodge County. Dodge County, this is two steps further than they were last year in a high-powered offense. Lithia Springs having to do it. They've done it through defense for the most part. So right now we're kind of seeing that Lithia Springs has been dictating pace when it comes to this particular game. So looking forward to seeing where the second half goes with this one right now tied at the break.
Scoreless and tied at the break. John, who do you think is going to have the momentum coming out in the second half? Where do you think it falls right now before the half ended?
Sins,
That's all right. All right. I don't think Nelly can hear us. That is A-OK. Let's go ahead and explain a few of the ways that you can follow us through our championship week. And you can catch us right here on your television or however that you're watching your screen, obviously live on GPB. We also will be broadcasting live on our Facebook. You can also join us at gpb.org/sports and watch us on the World Wide Web that way. And you can, of course, download our wonderful GPB Sports app and catch us there. Now, if you are in the social media world, which we hear from a lot of you and we love connecting with you, be sure to tag us, follow us, all of the things, because we are very active over there on our social media page, specifically our Twitter and our Facebook and Instagram. So be sure to follow us there at GPB Sports. So there are lots of ways that not only can you watch us, but you can share the ways to watch with all of your friends and family. We'd love to have you join us. Thanks so much for joining us right now. We'll be right back in just a moment. Stick with us.
Flint Energies and 30 other participating Georgia Electric membership cooperatives congratulate Sly County High School on winning the GHSA Cooperative Spirit Sportsmanship Award. This award honors schools that exhibit exemplary sportsmanship during competitive events. Only one school in each region within each classification is chosen to receive this annual award. The GHSA takes into consideration all aspects of sportsmanship, making the award a tribute to the entire community.
Sportsmanship is something that we do preach. We have great adult leaders of our kids, and we have great kids. The fact that they're able to exhibit that not just in everyday life, but also in athletics is extremely important to us. And to be honored with this award and see that pay off is a great honor.
Introduced in 2006, this award reinforces the GHSA's philosophy that everyone associated with high school activities, from athletes to spectators, should adhere to the fundamental values it represents.
We pride ourselves on helping the community, especially when it comes to education. To give this award to someone who we know recognizes it and really have demonstrated that they have proven what it really stands for, that's all the more so. We appreciate it. We are proud of it.
Georgia's EMCs and the 31 participating Georgia Electric Membership Cooperatives are proud to sponsor the Cooperative Spirit Sportsmanship Award. Congratulations to the Sly County Wildcats community.
Sweetheart, please don't forget to wear your seatbelt.
I got it, Mom.
It's a really nice day living in the right space. Breathing your breath got me feeling some kind of way.
In the blink of an eye, so many tomorrows can disappear. Buckle up for your future. Every trip, every time. A message from the Governor's Office of Highway Safety.
All right, what do you think, Jasper?
Honestly, I think that polyester shirt's affecting your game.
What?
I think cotton would have been a better choice.
Cotton?
Yeah, it's come a long way, you know. Nowadays, cotton breathes and looks moisture great. Plus, buying cotton means supporting Georgia farmers. I think that's wonderful.
Okay, sure, but what do you think about the putt?
Oh, guess really hadn't thought about it.
Today's conservation-minded consumer cares about where their energy comes from. Your local EMC cares, too. Georgia's electric membership cooperatives offer renewable options for our members. In fact, our solar portfolio will produce enough clean energy to power more than 180,000 households, striving to move the needle toward progress and position communities for the future. Georgia's EMCs, so much more than electricity.
It's a stalemate between Lithia Springs and Dodge County here in the Class 5A through 6A state flag football final at Center Park Stadium in downtown Atlanta. We are in Midtown Atlanta at our GPB studios. I'm Wiley Ballard, joined by the state's foremost leading rules expert in flag football, David Reynolds. And David, that first half, it's tight. Offense is hard to come by, and Lithia Springs' defense, to me, was the story.
Yeah, very stingy defense up front. Not overly excited about how sloppy it was from the penalties perspective. Nice job right there defensively, again, for Lithia Springs on interception. Gets a big pass breakup right there for Altair Gooch on defense.
And then how about this play towards the end of the first half? Fourth and six from the six. Hannah McIver swatting it away with some attitude. Here's a look at your first half stats. And suffice to say, Dodge County's offense not finding their rhythm. Lithia Springs, meanwhile, they just got to avoid those penalties. Nearly negated all their yardage.
Yeah, we say defense wins championships, and that's what we have. We also like to say, like I said, we clean up some of the penalties and the illegal contacts downfield to let the offense run around a little faster and fly around.
And those six-plus yard plays, only six of them in the game. There is head coach Kendra Pleasance. Her team is comfortable playing in these types of games, David. They have not scored more than 7 points in a playoff game during this run, but they have won all four of them. And I loved how she went about trying to learn the sport of flag football. She said, well, if I'm going to coach this sport, I got to know this sport. And the best way for me to know this sport is to play flag football myself. She competed in the Atlanta Women's Flag Football League and played receiver. And the league actually uses some of Lithia Springs' athletic facilities. And one of her assistants is Craig Davis, who was an opposing coach in that league. And when he found out that Lithia Springs was going to have their own high school team this fall, he said, well, I'd love to be an assistant. And currently conversations are ongoing trying to get Kendra to move to his team as a player instead of playing against him in the spring. But here we are, no score. Lithia Springs starts out first and six at their own 14. There are no kickoffs in flag football. You just start at the 14-yard line. Clint Sanders trying to bring it home for Dodge County down in Eastman, Georgia. 140 miles southeast here of the state's capital in Atlanta. And it's thrown up for grabs and caught. Hannah McIver pulls it in. Weaving right, makes a man miss inside the 20-yard line, if you will. And that'll be a 47-yard gain for Hannah McIver.
Sometimes you got to just take the chance. You got to risk it to get the biscuit. Number four right there, great hand. She's got gloves, makes another player miss. Keep playing, get up the field. Very nice job right there of a big play right there for Lithia Springs.
And at first, when she decelerated, I thought she had heard a whistle or a flag. And then it appeared that she thought her flag had been pulled. But it's going to come all the way back, and penalties just crushing Lithia Springs. Penalty was a legal contact on Lithia Springs.
Big time call there. Not only brings the whole play back, but then penalizes half a 10-yard penalty there. Excuse me, half the distance there. So puts them back behind being on schedule again for the offense.
And Kasasia West is in at quarterback. Leisha Miller is your center. West lets it fly again. That one off target. She was searching for Anaya Moore.
Yeah, freshman quarterback here. Definitely has the arm strength, best arm on the team. Trying to get the ball downfield a little more. Mixing up looks here for the Lions. Trying to make it more challenging for the Dodge County defense.
And this Lithia Springs team is a young, young group. They have no seniors, only three juniors. And we were talking to Coach Pleasance earlier this week, and she said, Kennedy, it really hasn't dawned on them what they're playing for. As West is sacked. Just barely pulled it in time. And credit Anaya Showers with taking down Kasasia West.
Yes, a little too much time just standing there, number 45, quarterback West. Just stands there, too much time, especially for that speedy rusher up front who already has 63 tackles coming into the ball game. Again, that anchor of the defense, reminding the Lithia Springs offense why she is that anchor.
Yeah, and Glenna Ray Whitley saying, well, I had the interception. So Coach Pleasance will have to punt. And this fielded again deep in Lithia Springs territory around the right side, turning up field. And finally, the flag pulled from behind, but a great return by Illeshia Mitchell, and a similar opportunity is shaping up for Dodge County with this time a 30-yard punt, but a 19-yard return, and they again have a short field, but a flag.
Number Number 14, Mitchell, plays both sides of the football, flies around, just exactly what you want as a student athlete after the ball game, leaves the field tired all the time because she's given max effort, gets the ball, gets back up field.
See anything there?
I believe the call was flag guarding. In flag football, we can't stiff arm, we can't guard our flags to prevent the opponent from reaching to the flag. I believe that's what you do with our left hand on the inside. It's a good call right there by the back judge, DJ Doss.
And Jones taking her shot and way off the mark. And it looks like Gooch pointing to herself saying, no, that's my me, I ran the wrong route.
That's exactly what you want from a leadership perspective. When you mess up, you take ownership and don't blame somebody else. So I'm sure the junior wide receiver will get that route fixed moving forward. Not a bad idea there. Going to run heavy for a little while for Dodge County, trying to get the ball downfield a little bit to start this drive with good territory, good position still.
And the passing game for Dodge, 1 for 7 today, -2 yards. Jones bumped up. That ball's up for grabs. Phillips had her mitts on it, but couldn't haul it in.
And personal foul, roughing the passer on the defense. 10-yard penalty, automatic, first down.
And that right there is the best offensive player of the day for Dodge County, a 15-yard roughing the passer penalty.
So it'll be a 10-yard penalty, and more importantly, it's an automatic first down. With flag football and roughing the passers, any contact on the passer's arm, we're going to get that. And then right there, the defender kind of goes low on the quarterback, initiating contact there. So very quick flag when it comes to roughing the passer.
Around the right side. And a good tackle right at the line of scrimmage. But this is a tough spot to be on the field, and this is where you kind of get a feeling for why where you are in the field makes such a difference. First and two, where you're only 3 yards away from being first and 19. As those yards to gain or lines to gain are fixed on a flag field, midfield, and then the two quote-unquote 20-yard lines, although they're 30-yard lines here on this tackle field, and then the 10-yard lines are the end zones. In other words, this is a tough line to gain to defend. And I don't know how, but Amani Roberts found a way through a wall of Dodge defenders.
So a different look there by the Dodge County offense, bringing everybody back inside and just trying to let your ball carry get up the field. Really good job here in the flagpole, short of line of the game. See everybody all seven right there in the middle. And like you said, Roberts up front just doing what she's doing all day long, pulling flags. Third and one here. Very manageable line to gain, but again, same look here, yeah.
You got to think it's two down territory anyway, and this will be close. Yeah. Looks like she got it, and she did. That's all Dodge was trying to establish there, just move the chains, and now they've got four shots to get in the end zone.
I'm pretty sure Lithia Springs, okay for them taking four plays or three plays to get 2 yards. Tough sledding right there. Now we have to get to the line, the goal line is the next line to gain, so cannot bunch them in much for this next four downs.
Scoreless here in the second half of this state championship game. Carson Etheridge with the grab.
They were ruled that an incomplete pass. Rolls out.
Oh, she did drop it. Beg your pardon. So you're the rules expert.
That is definitely an incomplete pass. We don't need to go to replay. Okay. Nobody throw the red flag out there. That's definitely an incomplete pass.
All right, second down and 20. Where's Jones going to go? On the right side. Tanaya Showers. That time with the carry.
Incredible speed here by the senior wide receiver, lined up as a running back at that play. But just super fast to get on the edge right there. But, Lithia Springs defense doing what the Lions have come here to do by pulling flags and limiting the big play.
And let's not discount the loss of Sinai Showers, or beg your pardon, Sinai Searles, star player for Dodge County, their leading rusher. She went down in the quarterfinal game. They found a way in the semifinal against Riverwood 13-6, but you can tell they're missing her presence today. Jones weaves past one defender, but Anaya Kendrick plucks the belt and brings up fourth down.
Yeah, Kendrick there, a middle linebacker, although we get really good pressure up front by Roberts.
Fourth down.
We get double zero. Kendrick just spying the quarterback like the elf on the shelf right there to pull the flag. Nice job right there, again, by Lithia Springs. Making a very challenging fourth down play here. I'm not quite sure what we can draw up in the dirt here for Dodge County.
Did you just drop an elf on the shelf on me?
Tis the season.
Tis the season. You are right. 10-yard line is the end zone. Dodge has got to get there on this play, or Lithia Springs will get the ball back. They go for it, and way too tall and a little long as well for Altiera Gooch.
Yeah, just take a shot right there. Why not? To no avail, though.
No score. We're approaching the midway point of this second half. Could come down to one play for a state championship. Lithia Springs, Dodge County, flag football on GPB Sports.
Hi, folks. Butch Miller from Milton Martin Honda in Gainesville. On the sidelines and having a great day. Ladies and gentlemen, if you believe Milton Martin Honda is squarely behind all our students and all their activities, you got that right.
Half of the nation's opioid overdoses happen right at home because people don't understand the dangers of taking an Oxy or Perc with a glass of alcohol for stress or to sleep. Learn how to protect your family from opioid overdose at opioidresponse.info.
Respect. It's more than a word. In the U.S. Army, respect is earned every day. Now, in addition to earning respect, you may qualify for more. Information at goarmy.com/bonus or 800-USA-ARMY. Paid for by the U.S. Army.
Well, Coach Clint Sanders trying to figure out a way to break through this stingy Lithia Springs defense. They have yet to do so far, or thus far, but they've gotten close inside the 10 twice, just haven't gotten any points. Now Lithia Springs perhaps looking for a home run or a drive of their own. State championship hangs in the balance. We are scoreless. Just over 10 minutes remaining and a running clock until the final minute. And this is a nice catch and run by Isaiah Phillips. Kasasia West hits her on the numbers. First down, Lithia Springs.
Yeah, nice pitch and catch here to the junior wide receiver. Little check down here. Get the ball on the edge. Again, get your athletes in space. Let them run around. And that's what number 10 did. Got the ball and got up the field very quickly to get the first down. Good start to the drive.
And Lithia Springs, as you can see, has outgained Dodge County significantly as a late flag comes in. A little tie up there between Myangel Ross and Micaiah Robertson. See what the penalty is.
Illegal contact on the defense. 10 yards we add at the end of the run. Replay, first down.
David, what is illegal contact in flag football?
So commonly we see it with the blocking techniques. That's one potential idea there. The other one is if you're not trying to pull the flag and you just either tackle her or anything above. So right there, number two, very aggressive, but just throws her opponent to the ground. And yeah, that's something we do not want in the game of flag football.
So now second down and six after the drop pass. And while Lithia Springs has gained more yards, it's actually Dodge County who's played the majority of the game on the Lions' side of the field. It's been the penalties that have been the undoing for Coach Pleasance and her Lions today. But still over 8 minutes, that clock will run all the way into the one-minute mark without stopping. No score.
Time will start to become a concern for both teams, starting to limit the amount of possessions that we'll have coming down the home stretch with 8 minutes to go.
Asasia West, she's been in quarterback most of the second half, hands it off, racing up the middle, flag pulled from behind. They go back to Isaiah Phillips. She had 32 yards rushing at half.
Really good effort here by the senior rusher. Again, Showers just blowing up the Lithia Springs offense today so far, applying the pressure. Even though it wasn't not a tackle for a loss, got the flag pulled right there for a short gain.
The game total now to 36 yards rushing. Third and four, big play here, or else it'll be decision time. West feathers it over the middle, caught by McIver, moves the chains, figuratively speaking.
Yeah, we don't have chains this morning or the first three games, Holly, but nice job here by the freshman quarterback, just faking the handoff and kind of moving a little bit, getting the defenders in space. Right there, wide open in the middle of the field, picks up the first down for Lithia Springs.
Well, West and McIver, that was the touchdown connection on that heroic fourth down late in the second half. Go ahead, score in the semifinals. Phillips around the right edge. Flag comes flying in from beyond the play.
Illegal contact on the defense. 10 yards from the end of the run. Replay, first down.
Wow, that's the second legal contact penalty against Dodge County on this drive.
It's a little inside handoff here, gets him on the edge. Again, just kind of throwing the opponent out of the way. Cannot use our hands to initiate contact. So all of the offensive players standing there, we can't just run right through her or throw her to the ground.
So first and six. Redirect from Anaya Moore, zigzagging her way through between the hashes. Let's see where they'll spot her.
So we pick up the first down, which unfortunately for the offense makes a very long first down. You want to have that second and one compared to the first and 19 in any football, right? And so we would have been short of the line of the game, maybe take a shot here, but now that we're beyond the line, the game, kind of manage the next four downs with the goal line being the line
to
gain.
Yep, goal to go. The end zone begins at the 10-yard line on this field, and a pre-snap penalty. Well,
false start on the offense. 5-yard penalty remains first down.
In the first half, it was Lithia Springs getting charged all the penalties. In the second half, Dodge has been called for 40 yards in penalties.
Yeah,
and Lithia Springs is now up to 7 penalties for 54 yards in this game, and Dodge is 5 for 45.
First and 25 is a whole lot more challenging than first and 20.
Yes, it is. First and 20 ain't easy either. You know, it's tougher than first and 25, the second and 25. Catch on fast. Another flag.
That's math.
Personal foul. Roughing the passer. On the defense. 10-yard penalty. Automatic. First down.
Wow. The penalties are becoming the story here. We got 4 minutes and 20 seconds left. And as just jointed as this game has been, and ugly, we're one heroic throw from Casasia West from Lithia Springs being in a great spot.
Yeah,
the end zone is just 15 yards away.
With flag football, it just takes one play. Can have a really bad day all along, but one play busts it open and changes the outcome of the ball game.
And Maya Moore tackled in the backfield. Carson Etheridge, senior. Nearly 50 tackles on the year in 15 games.
Yeah, that's nothing new for number 5 right there. Leads the team in pools. So she's just doing what she's come to Center Park to do today.
There is an overtime procedure in place. We saw a state final go to overtime last year where West Forsyth prevailed over Hill Grove in double overtime. So we're not at the risk of a tie here. And Lithia Springs has got to figure this will be their last chance to score in regulation, barring a turnover. And nearly sacked. Instead, the ball gets away looking for McIver. McIver wanted the flag. They said it was clean. Glenna Ray Whitley in on the coverage.
Super risky right there by 45, the quarterback. Almost stands in the pocket. Too long for Showers to get up the field. So, again, I've been saying number 18's name all day. Applies that pressure. Feet get tangled there. We've got nothing. But not a bad idea for the Lions to take a shot.
And even with 3 minutes to go, it's kind of like what we talked about, Dave. This is a good chance this will be the last time Lithia Springs has the ball in regulation with the way the clock will wind.
So the clock will run continuously to the one-minute mark, except for a team timeout, which you see right here. Not a bad idea by Coach Pleasants to call timeout, calm things down. A lot of underclassmen are out there playing football today, so it's a big moment. So get the correct play call in, the correct package in for the best opportunity of success. So heads-up idea right there by Coach Pleasants.
Coach Sanders wants his defense to bow up here. They've made Lithia Springs earn it. But those penalties have helped Lithia Springs a lot. I guess the point I'm making is the drive started way back on the 15-yard line. Some big penalties against Dodge County have helped the Lions move the football. 10-yard line to the end zone. West going for the gusto. A throw off target.
Yeah, take a shot right there to number 16.
Fourth down, offense.
Kind of surprised we don't just chop that distance down in half. So, be a third and 16. Maybe could have taken a little underneath route to pick up a couple yards. Instead, takes a shot. Not a bad idea, though. Good ball there. Just a little out of room. You see the gold line right there for flag football. That's the other sideline.
Timeout,
today.
Lithia Springs.
And again, we'll see our second timeout called here. Let's get the correct play call in from Coach Pleasants and staff. Get the right play call in because we don't know if we'll be back down here the rest of the day.
Again, that's staff joining head coach Kendra Pleasants, Rodney Cross, Trey Hightower, a couple of former Lithia Springs tackle football players, and the aforementioned Craig Davis, who is a flag coach here in the Metro Atlanta area for the Atlanta Women's Flag Football League. This sport has seen so much growth at the high school level over the last 4 years, but really beyond that. It's always been big in intramurals and college campuses, but it has been growing steadily. But right now, the focus on this play. Lithia Springs, I think in that huddle, it's either score here or we got to force overtime, right?
Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised if she were razzle-dazzle here, maybe a hook and ladder or something like that. Throwing a ball into the end zone here, 50-50 at best, so I wouldn't be surprised if we can mix something up right here.
Keeping it loose in the stands here at Center Park Stadium. The end zone is the 10-yard line. Fourth and 16. Goal to go. West over the middle, incomplete. And Dodge County stands tall. It was the Lions early in this one with a couple of goal line stands. Dodge County pulls one up to keep this game tied.
Yeah, even if this pass is completed, there's not a whole lot after it with the defense just swarming to the football right there. So, tough sledding right there as we get down to the red zone inside the 20-yard line.
All right, well, here we go. Dodge County has two timeouts at their disposal. They used one at the end of the first half. This is the first time they've had the ball since the 10-minute and 11-second mark. As Lithia Springs, if nothing else, killed the clock on that drive. And a tackle behind the line. That time it was Isaiah Phillips.
So the running game is not going to be the best approach here to be near the one-minute mark. Again, if you're Coach Sanders, maybe just say, let's take care of the football here. Let's not be too worried about taking any threats and give the ball back to the Lions. But been run heavy for most of the day, and I think we're going to continue that approach here in the last minute 10.
Suppose if you're Dodge County here saying, well, we haven't been able to move the ball in Lithia Springs all day. They've already forced one turnover, an interception. They picked off Annie Jones, the quarterback. Why don't we just take our shot in overtime with a shorter field and rely on our defense to slow down Lithia Springs from an equally short field?
Yeah, again, with the speed on the field and the athletes on the field for both teams, let's be smart here. Again, defense wins championships, especially if you're a big SEC fan, right? Defense wins championships.
I argue if either of these teams find any offense, they'll win the championship, Dave.
Got to score to win.
Yeah,
the
apparently.
The team that's going to score will win.
And turnovers are a big part of this game. You can steal possessions that way. We've seen only one today. Jones to the air. And it's caught! Altiera Gooch with a huge grab down the left side. Annie Jones with her best throw of the day.
So I stand correct, and that's why I'm in this booth and not coaching. Takes a bomb right there to the my impact play at the beginning of the game. Picks up the first down. Two timeouts here, so if we want it, a little more excitement, we got to keep going. But nice job pitch and catch right there. Good hands by Altiera Gooch.
So a 20-yard grab. Clock under 40 seconds now. The end zone is the 10-yard line on this field. 45 yards away. Jones floats it high. It's intercepted. Another pick for Anaya Moore. And now Lithia Springs has a chance to win it late. Anaya Moore came to play.
Junior free safety had a big interception as well in the semifinal matchup versus Greenbrier. And again, nothing gets past her. Just when Dodge County thinks they've got something going on, Anaya Moore says, not today.
Well, let's see what Kasasia West and the Lions can pull up here. Keep in mind, West, she had that game-winning touchdown pass in the final 5 minutes of the semifinals. When she threw it, it was a 35-yard bomb on fourth down. And instead of going to celebrate in the end zone, she just sort of schlepped over to the sideline. Taking a deep shot over the middle. Is it incomplete? Gooch had it in her fingertips and couldn't maintain control. I think we're just going to see some shots towards the end zone here, don't you?
Yeah, for sure. Let's find a way to block number 18 up front as much as possible, max protection, and then get the ball downfield and just see what happens. Let the athletes be athletes. Here, double coverage, maybe ill-advised, but yeah, for the last 20 seconds, let's just take shots. I've been wrong before, though, one time.
I think a little hand up the middle here. Lithia Springs does have a timeout. Overtime, should we get there, is similar to college football and high school football rules. And interesting, seeing Coach Pleasance wants to call the timeout here just as the
timeout, Lithia Springs.
Clock has stopped. So they'll put it back up at 20 seconds, I'm sure. Interesting to see the timeout taken there. So 23 seconds on the clock. What can Coach Pleasance draw up?
Yeah,
they
yeah.
went to Hannah McIver in a similar spot on Monday.
Yeah, when you have success doing something like that, although it's a 50-50 play being a kind of a bomb in the pass, why not right here? Take the shot. You got an opportunity. Even if you throw an interception in this side of the field, it's a long field for Dodge County, not a whole lot of time. So let's just see what happens. It's your first year playing flag football on the biggest stage of the game. What else do you want?
So ball just a yard ahead of midfield. West over the middle, incomplete. The clock will stop with 17 seconds.
Yeah, a little feet tangle right there. No harm, no foul. Third down now. Might be trying to go underneath right there just to make sure that we don't have a short pass, short incomplete pass and stopping the clock. We don't want to give the ball back. If you're Lithia Springs, don't want to give the ball back to Dodge County for any kind of Hail Mary of any sorts.
Now, if they go short and complete it, the clock will run. And no timeouts. Instead, West is sacked. And now Dodge has an option to call a timeout if they want to try and get the ball back, or they can settle for overtime. And sure looks like they will settle for overtime. And that's what we got. No score through two halves. We're going to overtime. And the Class 5A through 6A state championship. We will have a coin toss to determine who goes on defense first. But the overtime rules, David, they come into sharp focus here now.
Hey, so got to have a winner here. We came to give somebody a trophy, so we need some extra time, and that's fine too. So what we'll see coming out of this coin toss is one team will start at the 15-yard line and going in. So it'll be first down and 15 with the line to gain the goal line. Both teams get one timeout per period, similar to high school and college football. Both teams get a possession. So if one team scores first, we got to flip it, and the other team gets an opportunity. Slight difference here, though, the defense does get the possession of the football. The drive is over, and the other team gets the football. So no pick sixes, although that'd be very exciting to see a 75-yard interception return. But none of that in overtime here for flag football. One timeout. Going in.
They're explaining the rules about the overtime tosses. And I think Annie Jones, she was spotted on camera.
Can't come to Atlanta and be camera shy, right? I mean, you're on the biggest stage of this sport. Come on, enjoy it. Similar to tackle football, when we have a coin toss, won't be surprised if the winner picks defense, right?
Well, here's Lithia Springs. Let's see what we can hear. So no score, Lithian Springs, Dodge County through all of regulation. Portal lost 20-0 to Southeast Bullock, who won the state championship in game one.
Coaches, congratulations on making it this far. We've had very clean games, so good work on that. Please just maintain the sportsmanship throughout the overtime period. It'll be the same as high school tackle rules. Each team will have four possessions, beginning four downs, beginning on the 15-yard line going in. You'll have one timeout per overtime period. Do you have any questions about any of the overtime rules? This is my coin, same as before. This will be heads, this will be tails, heads and tails. Lithia Springs, you're the away team. What's your choice? She said heads, we're gonna let it hit the ground. It is tails. Dodge County, you have won the toss. What is your decision? Dodge County would like to start on defense. You'll start on offense. Would you like to go towards the scoreboard? Perfect. Can you rotate that way, please? Perfect. Dodge County has won the toss and elected to begin on defense. Lithia Springs.
That ceremony executed brilliantly by our head referee, Ian Busey. And Coach Sanders clapping to his team, saying, hey, we got a stop and a score, and we've got rings. Lithia Springs has other ideas. Well, here we go, and I'll say one name I'm surprised we haven't heard as much from here, Dave, is Nevaeh Shedrick, team's leader in carries and rushing yards. She has not been as involved today.
And that's probably my fault. I picked her as an impact player, so sometimes that happens there. But, you know, that's a shout-out there to the Dodge County defense for locking down number nine in her running game that's been just completely electric all season long.
And I think what you saw there was Illeshia Mitchell and Anaya Shower spotting themselves on the big screen up at the Jumbotron. Yep, there we are.
Hey, we're excited. We're here.
It feels big time, doesn't
it? Come on, let's go.
Overtime. Here we are. The end zone is the 10-yard line. By the way, Nevaeh Shedrick, four carries, 16 yards, not a single touch in the second half. That's number nine in white. They've been going to Isaiah Phillips, who is to the left of West, and she gets the ball around the right side, and a great pull behind the line. Boy, tackles for loss all over the place today. That one belongs to Anaya Showers.
You know, again, Lithia Spring known for their speed, but again, Anaya Showers up front, senior rusher, just getting after it all day long. She's going to be exhausted. Either way, headed back to Eastman, Georgia today.
Second year as a team captain. She was voted the team captain last year as a junior, even though Dodge had some other seniors on the team. West over the middle, dumps it off, caught by McIver. And there to pull the flag, Illeshia Mitchell.
Right, so we're first down, 15 yards to go, so we know we're in four down territory. Let's just see if we can get a couple yards each play, stay on time, stay on track to get across the goal line. Obviously, like all day, you know, once you catch the ball down here on this end of the field, we know it's going to be tough sledding from there, so we'll see what happens if we can cut the distance down here on third down.
Two plays to get 12 yards here at Center Park Stadium. Little play fake, ball swatted in the air. Anaya Showers is everywhere.
Quarterback tries to take a little shot in the corner of the end zone. And up front for defense again. This is why we moved number 18 from linebacker to rush. Just jumps up. Nice job, not of contacting the quarterback. Nice pass breakup right there, giving Dodge County another shot.
All right, one more shot. Fourth and 12. Did she get it away? Doesn't matter. Incomplete or a sack. Either way, Lithia Springs cannot score. Now Dodge County, if they can get in the end zone, they will be state champions.
Real simple offensive strategy here. Let's just get the ball in the end zone. Let's just score real quick and win a state championship. Maybe not as easy to do with both defenses on the field today. But again, first down and 15. First down and goal from the 15.
Let's see where Coach Sanders wants to go. Manny Jones. Then Altiera Gooch for a big pass play towards the end of regulation. Jones is going to run with the fake. She's down to the 20-yard line on this tackle football field. The end zone is the 10. Good positive play on first down.
I like the misdirection right here. Letting the rusher kind of take herself out of the play, keeping the ball for the quarterback there, and just chip in away. Get a couple yards. We don't need a big play here. Although those big guard yards are awesome to have in flag football when it's first and 15. Let's just get a couple yards at a time.
It's a gain of 5. They get to the 10-yard line in this field. They are state champions. That's the end zone. And nearly dropped on a snap. Ball is fumbled, and it is dead as soon as it hits the ground. So although it was recovered by Lithia Springs, it's still Dodge County ball, but they do lose 3 yards.
We've seen several either missed snaps or missed handoffs, and here we have another one, a really bad time for the Dodge County offense. They're used to the misdirection. They're used to people going different directions, so they're not doing anything new today, just not executing as highly as they probably want to be.
Both these teams gave up just 3 points per game in the regular season. No surprise they struggled to score. Is that pass? Oh, the interception dropped by Nevaeh Shedrick. That would have forced a second overtime. She could not have run it back. But now Dodge County does have one more opportunity.
Kind of moves the quarterback on a, moving her out of the pocket there a little bit. Probably the wrong read. Either the receiver quarterback not on the same page there. Might have had somebody over the top here to throw it to, but to no avail there on third down.
So here you go. It's a direct snap to Mitchell, and her flag comes off. Whether it fell off or was pulled off, it's one-hand touch if it's deemed to have just fallen off. So either way, she is down, and just like that, Dave, double overtime.
Why not?
Somebody's got to score.
I've got nothing else to do today besides watch really good flag football. And that's what we get on this last play of the first overtime period. Really good effort there, laying out, pulling the flag. Yeah, that's off. Nice job, number 23, Roberts up front. And so we'll kind of flip offense, defense here. And so we'll see Lithia Springs back on offense to start the second overtime period.
What? You're saying to start? Is it not their choice? Because Lithia Springs started on defense, right? So, okay, it'll be Dodge County ball to start. Okay. Yep. So that's Dodge County will this time start on offense. And Dave, where do you go in your playbook right now? Neither team has really had much success doing much of anything. And to be fair, it seems like these defenses have been at their best and the field's been the shortest.
Yeah, so I'm no Tony Romo here, but if I'm Coach Sanders, the misdirection has seemed to have a little bit of success offensively. Maybe no big plays necessarily, but just finding a way to get down the field a couple yards per play to where we can get the ball in the end zone here.
Coach Sanders trying to find something that can get his team in the end zone.
Lithia Springs has elected to begin the second overtime period on defense.
So it is their choice, but no surprise. Ina Purvis to snap for Dodge. Again, the 10-yard line is the end zone. Jones, a quick release, and it's batted away. Broken up by Isaiah Phillips.
Nice job right there, flying to the football. Probably set up a little bit of a hook and ladder here with the back out of the backfield. I think that pitch was going to go to Mitchell, but again, too fast on defense to allow it to happen by the junior linebacker. Nice job breaking that pass up.
We're in double overtime, and Dodge's total offense has amounted to 37 yards. Jones swallowed up, out of bounds. Well out of bounds. Looked like Micaiah Robertson lost track of where she was in the field.
So maybe it's new for us, for this flag football field to be in the big old stadium that we see here. But these girls have been playing on this style of field. They've been playing on a football field all year long. So, yeah, we kind of just lose where we're at there. Of course, she's open because she's out of bounds, but that'll be an incomplete intended for Robertson, excuse me.
So nothing on those first two plays. I mean, it just has the feeling of one play, one mistake is going to define this game. Maybe one great play. Here's Annie Jones redirecting inside the five, and her flag is pulled at the six or so. And it'll be fourth down.
Nice, relentless effort here on number eight. Annie Jones, nothing to the right. Let's just give it a shot to the left. Picks up several yards. Great pursuit by the linebacker, Kendrick, there to keep that ball out of the end zone. But this is what it's all about. Everybody diving all over the place. Max effort. A lot on the line right here in double overtime.
And it's fourth down. Anaya Kendrick with the touchdown saving pull. Those numbers aren't pretty, but if it ends with a score on this play, she'll be just fine. Lithia Springs will get the ball back no matter what happens on this play. Jones, incomplete. Lithia Springs had that one tracked the whole way. It was intended for Anaya Showers, and now the Lions have a chance to win it with a sudden death score.
Looked a little confused on that play about where the ball was supposed to go and to who, but not the best executed play by the offense there, but again, Lithia Springs defense, you've been talking about it all day long. Stout defense. Nice job of giving yourself a chance here on offense to put the ball in the end zone.
Well, it was double overtime last year when West Forsyth outlasted Hillgrove. And Lithia Springs pulled off in double overtime here in year two of GHSA Flag Football Championships. Good stop by Illeshia Mitchell. Isaiah Phillips with the carry. She has gotten plenty of touches today.
Yeah, same kind of play here, just different direction. been running this play for the most part to the top of your screen all day long. And try a little different here by trying to get the ball to your speedy wide receiver Phillips there. Again, Dodge County sniffing that one out.
They've gone with Rashaya Minix in at quarterback here. We saw a lot of Kasasia West, who's got the better arm. Looks like Lithia Springs may try and run it in here. The redirection and a good pull by Anaya Showers. And right now, both defenses just haven't shown a single weakness. It feels somewhat like you ought to make it just to where if the defense gets the ball, they can score. That might be the best shot for either team.
Yeah, so just speed on speed out there. Very big-time athletes, both sides of the ball. And just pulling the flag the first time you can prevents the big play. So, yes, very stingy defense so far.
West is back in. She's got the arm going to the end zone. Overshoots her target. Looked like McIver and Whitley got tied up there. Good defense by the freshman safety.
Yeah, number four kind of just stops on her route a little bit. And nobody home in the back corner of the end zone. So bring up fourth down and 12 here. Again, tough sledding all day long.
They've got a chance to win it on this play. The 10-yard line is the end zone. Double overtime. West claps for the snap. And she is sacked. We go to triple overtime. Who's going to blink? This staring contest continues.
So again, freshman quarterback, maybe just not having that internal clock here about getting rid of the football a little quicker, stands in the pocket a little too long. And I don't know, was that her 44th sack of the day by Showers up front?
Feels
again,
that way.
Again, relentless pursuit. You know, in flag football, the rusher plays a critical part of the defense, and we've seen that on display on both sides of both clubs today. Slight rule change here as we head to the third overtime. Not that this has pertained too much to anybody, but if we score here, we do have to go for at least two. That would be one of the concerns, the rule changes going to the third overtime.
I know we haven't had...
Dodge County has elected to begin on defense. Starting with this third overtime period, it'll be from the 10-yard line, and teams will have to go for at least two following a touchdown.
So a slight rule change here. Again, the second part is that we're going to move the ball to the 10-yard line, cutting that distance down a little bit for the offense. So first and goal from the 10-yard line to start this overtime possession.
Again, the 10-yard line on the field is the end zone. So this 20 serves as the 10, and another tackle in the backfield. And you can see a little frustration building there for Isaiah Phillips. And say what you will, both these defenses have just been relentless. I mean, I know that's not as stereotypically exciting, but I mean, what Anaya Showers and Imani Roberts, the two rushers in this game, have done today has been nothing short of remarkable.
Again, if you pull that flag the first time, it'll give the offense havoc all day. I've not seen a miss pull by Showers all day long.
I haven't seen a miss pull by almost anybody. Minix might throw this time. Instead, she's going to be sacked way behind the line. And right now, Lithia Springs can't even get a positive playoff right now against Anaya Showers.
Yes, the sophomore quarterback rolls to her right. She actually gets outside of the blockers, which is kind of defeats the purpose offensively to where the rusher can get right there and apply the pressure in a hurry. Some growing concerns there. Being a first-year program, playing with a lot of underclassmen, still learning the game of flag football.
Now Kasasia West is in. She's got the bigger arm. Batted at the line of scrimmage by Showers. My goodness, every play. I'll tell you what, if she makes this play on fourth down, she better look at that offense and say, okay, I've done my part. How about the senior rusher, team's leading tackler? No surprise, she's been the anchor defensively for this group all season long, a two-year captain. And she's playing some of her best flag in this state championship, especially in these overtime periods. Triple overtime, no score. Play clock winding down. West has time to float it high, and it's just over the head of Hannah McIver. And yet another scoreless overtime session. Lithia Springs can't get it across. Now their defense needs to try and force a fourth overtime period. This time they'll do it from the 10.
Yeah, just taking a shot here again, looking for some kind of miracle, some kind of some hope here. Get the ball in the air and just see what happens. And again, we overthrow our target here on fourth down.
So Dodge County has a chance to win it if they can score. The 10-yard line is the end zone. Jones weaving up, and her flag pulled as she was streaking towards the end zone. Nice pull there by Isaiah Phillips.
Again, we're on the 10-yard line here, okay, so all we need is just get up the field a little bit. Every single play, got four downs to score. Give me some kind of positive gain here, and we get that. Again, good flag pull there defensively by Phillips.
7 yards away from a state championship. And a deep, deep starting point for Jones. She's looking to throw it over the middle. Batted away at the last moment by Hannah McIver. The state championship is at the fingertips of Hope Sheffield, and it was swatted away. Fiber had a huge breakup at the end.
On the defense, the defender removed the flag ball prior to the ball arriving. Half the distance to the goal, replay, second down.
Wow.
It's an interesting rule here. Can't pull the flag belt on somebody without the ball. And so we see the flag pull right there against the Purvis, the center. Pull the flag. There's a really good catch there by the official.
So it was not on the receiver. I was looking at the receiver. That was your flag. Here's Jones to win a state championship. Oh, just a hair too tall for her intended receiver. That was Sky Meadows. But
yeah, I like the option idea, right? So we're going to run it until the defense gets in front of my face, and then having the eye discipline downfield, still looking for a target. So that would have been a tackle for loss. So nice job just giving your offense a shot. Get the ball in the end zone.
Third down, 3 yards away. It's Mitchell down the right side in the end zone. Illeshia Mitchell scores in Dodge County, the state champions in 2021. Of elation and devastation between Dodge County, the champions, and Lithia Springs, a triple overtime thriller. We did not see a score until the final play of the game. It was Illeshia Mitchell, the senior running back, who broke the scoreless drought, and those tears are flowing. Just tells you how much they care. One more look at the game winner. The championship winner. And that block there by Tajanique Walker, a big part of that play. Illeshia Mitchell, after that semifinal win, she and her teammates. What a moment. And congratulations to Coach Kendra Pleasance, leading her team to a runner-up finish in their first season of flag football. Dodge County's the winner with Clint Sanders as their head coach. And again, Dodge County, they went to the College Football Hall of Fame after that semifinal win. And Illeshia Mitchell, who was the MVP of that game for Coach Sanders, looked at Coach as she was sitting down saying, Coach, I am tired. I think it's safe to say she is worn out after a 3-overtime state championship game. Dodge County wins it. Hugs all around for the Indians. Man, triple overtime. No score into the final play. That is a memorable state final. Hadn't seen one quite like that before.
A lot of defense wins championships. You see it here on again today.
And now we've got John Nelson, who's on the scene with a trophy ceremony.
Thank you very much, Wiley Ballard. It is that time where we present the trophy to our friends from Eastman. First and foremost, their first season, tremendous work from Lithia Springs, great work from Coach Pleasant and the Lions. Thanks for hanging out with us today. Fantastic season for Lithia Springs. But now, time to present the trophy. And to do that, the executive director of the Georgia High School Association, Dr. Robin Hines.
Wow, what a game. How about a big hand for both of these teams? It took 3 overtimes to get it done, but you're taking the state championship back to Eastman. Congratulations.
Thank you.
What do you have to say about it, Coach?
This is for these girls right there. They've worked hard for 2 years for this right here. It's for Dodge County, too.
So, Coach, what has this run been like? You've won games in different ways. This one, you had to do a little free football to do it. How does it feel to have that in your hand right now, the way that you've done this season?
With all the adversity we've gone through recently, this is amazing. And had to deal with it. Just the end of the season, it's been tough. So, but this is all worth it.
And to have a moment like this, with the season that you've had, with everything that you just talked about, obviously, it makes it that much more special to bring a trophy home to Dodge County and Eastman like this.
It does. It does. We've been waiting a long time for a football championship trophy in Dodge County, and we've got one now.
Coach Sanders, congratulations. Congratulations, Eastman, Dodge County champs in flag football for championship game 2 of 3 here in 2021. Wiley Ballard, take us home.
Thanks, Nell. Thank you, Nelly. Congratulations again to Dodge County. And how about Coach Sanders? He's not from Dodge County, but his wife, Rhonda, is born and raised there. And Dodge County has been home for him his 16th year working with the school, and a state championship win here on this Thursday afternoon in December. To wrap this one up, triple overtime, scoreless all the way into the final play. David, had we seen anything like that before?
No. Sometimes you have high-powered offense and a lot of points scored. That was not the case today. Two stingy defenses. Again, number 18 up front for Dodge County, flying around, applying that pressure. And then number 14 scoring that last touchdown. Stepping up when his team needs her was really fun to see.
Let's take a look at the highlights from this one. It began with a handshake at the start of overtime. That's where we picked it up. And how about this defensive play? Anaya Showers, the team captain. She got them into that third overtime period. And then Annie Jones rolling right, weaving up, cut the distance in half. And now here's the winner, Illeshia Mitchell, filling in for Sinai Searles, their star rusher who is out today. And Illeshia Mitchell, the walk-off winner. Number one, Dodge County, the state champions, as they bring it home, Class 5A through 6A. We've got so much more in store for you, not just the rest of this week, but we're talking about, in just a little short time, we've got our Class 7A Flag Football Championship, our final flag football game of this week. It features the Hillgrove Hawks and the Marietta Blue Devils. Third time they've met this year, coming up next. For David Reynolds, I'm Wiley Ballard saying so long. Only for a minute, Nikki Noto's got you covered for our in-between game coverage. Dodge County, state champions.